that's your greatest, like, asset? Is, like, how much of an angel you are? It's like, you being mean is actually meaner than mean people being mean. It's like, all you do is, like, give a look. And it's like, what am I doing? Most people. You're special, man. Yes, I like to think so.
Now I feel all self-conscious. Oh, no, not at all.
Because you're fucking, like, young, healthy, and fucking gorgeous, and balling. I don't either. That's a good thing. Not being an asshole towards women is a great, like, that's, you know, people that mack on girls are scumbags. You know what I mean?
There's people who can establish connection.
Yeah, but there's like a middle road, you know? You just gotta find that middle road where you're like...
Oh yeah, remember that girl you were making out on the stairs?
Christine?
Yeah.
Yeah.
When you came up here, and after that you were like... Okay, said you didn't give up home?
I wasn't all that pissed. I didn't really actually want to have sex with her. I just wanted to make out with her. Not interested in her. The only reason we made out was because she said, "I hate Vice." And when she said that, I was like, and we've been talking about literature and stuff. We kind of clicked a little bit, you know, but. I mean, she's a fun girl, and I'm
just
not...
Started making out with her because she said she hated
Vice. That's basically the extent of it, yeah. She said she hates Vice, and then she walked off. And then when she came back, I was like, I cut her off before she got to the party, and I was like, hey, I got a weird question for you. She's like, what? A big smile, I was like, you want to make out? And she's like, yeah. I was like, sweet, go that way. And then we snuck up here. I tried to get in Alex's room, but locked. No one's gonna invade your space, you know.
Why didn't you go to her room?
Because the place was packed full of people over there. There wasn't no sneaking anywhere if we went over there. It'd been like...
I could see if you were past.
I'm not an adult, man. I don't know if you know this about me, but I'm a big kid. And I will die a big kid.
Well, everyone
else is out of here. Well, they're fucked up. They don't know me then.
Physically speaking,
I'm adult size. Yeah. I'm full grown, if that's what you mean.
So you're a full grown person. You don't need to sneak around and trying to make out with like,
but that was the fun of it. It was cute like that, you know? Teenagers. I'm just going to be celibate. I've decided.
I'm pretty bored of it.
I was celibate for a year before. Like, when I was a teenager, girls just kind of threw themselves at me. I never had any problem getting with girls at all. And after 5 years of that, I was like, I just want to be alone. You know? Because it's always a hassle. Like, no matter what. Always drama, and it just slows you down if you're like actually trying to accomplish things. You know, if that's all you're trying to accomplish, see, that's whenever I like, that's when my game changed, was when I started writing this book. Sudden it became a research. You know? It's like, well,
yeah, I'm kind of worried about this girl. What she did. She's not like a serial.
You're in the Bay, dude. There's no such thing as, like, dating here. People don't date. They hook up and then they see each other down the road. And they hook up again. Yeah, because we're not like that. And that's why me and you have trouble.
I don't know if you're not. Most of my friends are in serious relationships.
Well, that's because they're weirdos and...
I know. It's pretty weird.
Well... Okay. Maybe Oakland is different than across the country. In San Francisco, there's no dating. There's like, even if you are dating, it's still like an open relationship. You know? Things are different here. Like, women run the show and women have, you know, different views. Like, when women are in charge, I don't know, I generalize a lot and people get mad. But, I look at things from a big picture perspective, you know, and that's generalizing. Look at me like I'm an adult.
Really?